गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री, क्लास सिक्स हिस्ट्री. सो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज ए वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर एज यू ऑल आर इन क्लास सिक्स. सो दिस चैप्टर इज न्यू, दिस सब्जेक्ट इज न्यू फॉर यू एंड इट इज अ वेरी हेल्पफुल चैप्टर. सो इन दिस चैप्टर विल इन्फॉर्म अस एंड इट विल हेल्प अस टू अंडरस्टैंड मोर व्हाट आर द थिंग्स we can learn from the history. So student, this chapter, as you know that it is written about in this chapter, like the chapter name is what, where, how and when. So student, it means what we can learn here, what happened. Suppose anything happened in history, you learn about what happened in that war. You know that different war happened in history, different kings were crowned, and it is the life of different king, how a king fought the war, what the result did that king get. So what happened in that war, whether the king won or the king lost that battle, where that battle was happened, in which place, how, what was the situation in that battle, how both the kings were fighting, when, in which year that battle was fought. So student, these are the meaning. Suppose in any incident, all the detailed information, what happened there, where that happened, in which place, how that happened, and when, in which year that happened. So student, these are the information we will learn in the history of every chapter in details. Those information which I told, what, where, how and when. So these are the information we will get. So student, as this is a new chapter, and from the class 6 your history starts. So in the beginning, and this is in this first chapter, you will learn about how history will help you. So student, if you will go to your book, it is written about a girl, Rasida. He read somewhere, and when he was reading one thing, he found that it was written that Rasida sat reading the newspaper. So that girl was reading a newspaper. So suddenly what happened to her? Her eyes fall on a small headline. And there it was written 100 years ago. How she wondered. And she wondered that how people are understanding and getting the information about a thing or an event which happened before 100 years ago. How people are getting the information, where they are getting the where, from which place this information people collects. Could anyone know that what happened so many years ago? Is it possible to know that what happened in the 100 years ago, 1000 years ago? So generally what happened in the yesterday or before in the last year. Suppose you whatever happened in the yesterday, you get in the newspaper, and what happened in the last year, the person who remember the thing, you ask your friend, or you ask you see in the newspaper, or like you ask your family member and relatives. So, and you ask them, do you remember this thing happened in which year? And you are like, you ask, can you tell me in which year the India won the last World Cup? Then your family member tells you 2011. But what happened? What was the condition of a thing 1000 years ago? So how will you know that? So in the history, we will learn how the past information, the events of the past, and the incident of the past, the war which happened in the past, the life of the people of the past, and about the occupation of the people of the past, society of the past, how those things were in the past. We will read those things. What were the condition? How was the life? What were the occupation? All these things which happened in the past, now in the history, we will learn. So from there, you can know that what were those things in the past and how those things nowadays. Maybe the life of people, maybe the society, maybe about the transportation, maybe about the communication. Like now you have an advanced mode of communication like internet, telephone, and all these things are there. So in the early time, the 1000 years ago, how people were communicating, whether they were communicating or what were the modes were there. So all these things we will compare from the history, and you can have the knowledge and idea about the past life. So it is written in the first point, in the first topic you will read, what can we know about the past? So as I told you, it is written that there are several things we can find out about the past. What were people eating, the kinds of clothes they wore, and the houses in which they were living. And we can find out about the lives of hunters and herders, farmers, rulers, merchants, priests, craft persons, artists, musician and scientist, all those person at that time, how they were doing, about how the their lives were, how they are sparing their lives, what they were doing, what they were what was the condition of their profession, what they were doing for the, they were doing for the society, how people were getting benefited from those people. We will know those things in these things we know from the history. Along with that, we can also find out about the what are the games children were playing, and the story they heard, and the place they saw, and the place they saw, what are the game they were playing, what are the song they were singing, everything student the point which I discussed. So how they were doing, so those things we can know from the history. What these things, how these things were in the past, so that you can compare about the life of the people and currently how much we have progressed. Though from, if you compare the past, if you know the past, then if you compare that, they can understand that how we are progressing and what are the condition. Okay, so next point, it is written in your book, where did people live? So now we understood that what were the things we will understand from the past. Then you are thinking about that, how they were living, where people were living in the past, whether they were living the nowadays like in a safety area, in a good cleaned area, or in a good infrastructure like building, apartment, or which places they were living in the past. So student, in the past, people have lived along with the banks of the river. Near the banks, they were living, so that they were in the nearby areas. They were collecting the foods, whatever they were required. So these rivers for several hundred thousands years ago. So for 1000 years, people were staying near the river banks. Okay, and some of the earliest people who lived were skilled gatherers, that is people who gathered their food. Gathers means they were moving, and they were going from one place to another. They were searching the food, they were collecting the food, and they were gathering the food. So at that time, in the beginning, people were not aware of the cultivation. So how they will eat the food? They will collect from the different trees, nearby areas, whatever the food, the thing they were, the food they were thinking that can be eatable. They collect those foods and they eat those food. Okay? So earlier people were sparing a life of the gatherers. Gatherer means those who gathered the food and collect the food. Those who gather by collecting the food. So student, the people who they knew about the vast wealth of plants in the nearby areas. Whatever the plants are there, which foods can be eaten. So they were aware of that. So they were collecting roots, fruits and other forest produce for their food. So which fruits they can they will eat, or which foods they should not collect, which roots can be eaten, like sweet potatoes, that is a root they were eating, and about the fruits and about other things also. So those things they were collecting and eating. They also hunted animals. So they at that time they were hunting the animals also. So student, like these people were staying near the near of the banks, and they were sparing the lives. Okay, so the first they were sparing and they were staying in the river Narmada, in the banks of the river Narmada. The first civilization they have started, and later on they will change, and they were doing different thing in the Narmada river. They were staying near the Narmada river, and they were collecting their food. So next is that some of the areas where women and men first began to grow crops such as wheat and barley about 8000 years ago are located here. So student, in the northeast part, in the northeast of our country, so in the northeast Garo Hills is there. Garo Hill is in the Assam. So in that part, people first started cultivation about barley and wheat before 8000 years ago. So people also began rearing animals like sheep, goat, cattle, and lived in the villages. So gradually, after the gatherers, hunters and gatherers, like people were collecting the gathering the food by collecting, hunting the animals. Later they were doing in the Garo Hill areas. They were cultivating the wheat and barley. Student, you note down this. The people first cultivated in the Garo Hills area 8000 years ago, and the first crop was wheat and barley. This is the important point. You note down this. Later on, they also reared the animals like sheep, goats, cattle, all these things, and they started living in the villages. After the rear, so they moved to the villages, from the river bank to the villages. Okay, gradually they shifted. So student, you can find out about the Garo Hills on the physical map of India, and along with that Vindhyas. Okay, Vindhyas, Vindhya, which is in the central India. These were some of the other area agriculture developed. So along with the northeast Garo Hills, which is in the Assam, in the central India, Vindhya mountains, in those areas after the Garo Hills, the agriculture developed in the Vindhya hill area, which is in the central India. So the places where rice was fast grown are to the north of the Vindhyas. So student, now rice has started cultivation in the north of the Vindhyas. So now people understood the cultivation of the rice. So they have produced the rice. Now they have grown the rice, and the first people grown rice in the north part of the Vindhya river. So student, you must locate the Vindhya areas where people first grown the rice, and you also locate the Garo Hills where people grown the wheat and barley before 8000 years ago. These are the important points which we should locate. So student, next thing, how people were started living in a good place. So we will discuss that topic later. So thank you for attending today's class.